So I know last time I made a story time video, I said I'd never do it again because it was so much work, but I don't know. I guess I just have too many good stories not to tell, along with a bit of a masochistic streak. So I guess we're doing this again. This story takes place at Akon in Fort Worth, Texas, a couple of years back. It was my first legitimately big convention that myself and a few of my friends traveled to. It was a blast, but probably also spawned one of my most infamous stories. A bit of context first. So when I go to conventions, I like going solo. Basically, I ditch all of my friends and try to make as many new friends as possible. I know, sounds mean, but hear me out. You can hang out with these recurring characters anytime you please, but at anime conventions you can meet a ton of new characters or one-off characters knowing that you already have something in common. Honestly, I've made a ton of friends through this manner. Not to mention, I always warn everyone that I'm going with that I always do this. So at Akon, that's exactly what I did. I went around looking for new people to hang out with. And I'm gonna be honest, I don't really know what was up with me because I just kept striking out. Every group I approached either clearly didn't want me there or would try their best to ditch me as soon as possible. It was honestly a bit harsh. So here I am, sitting on the escalator, when I noticed a cosplayer was standing by herself in front of me. I decided to give it one more go. Her name was Asuna. Her name was totally not Asuna. And she was at the con solo as well, and we hit it off pretty well and decided to go to a few panels together. So time for a little bit of harsh reality to you all. You see, I am of the male gender, which generally means we pursue the female gender from tickling. Yeah, let's go with that. So here's an awesome tip for both you guys and girls at anime conventions who just want to, double check your tickling partner's age without coming off like a complete creep. It's actually quite simple. Invite them to an 18 plus panel. If their answer is no, that's a huge red flag. If their answer is maybe, we'll see, run. But if their answer is yes, so bring them to the panel to double check. Feel free to use this little tip at your own discretion. So we start planning out what panels we're going to, and then she insists on going to a specific 18 plus panel. That's like two green flags. Now that I think about it, Asuna was probably just using the same trick on me. Either way, we spend the whole day together. We go to that 18 plus panel, have a blast, and we even agree on meeting up tomorrow to hang out again. So the next day starts, and I come out with a plan. You see, today was Saturday, the last full day of the convention. So if any tickling was going to happen, today was the day. You see, I actually had a room at the convention itself, but I was sharing it with some friends and I knew later that night they would all be in the room drinking. So I had a solid 5 to 6 hours where I should be able to lay claim to the room without any problems. So Asuna and I meet up, we walk around the convention for an hour or two, and I was just so tired and really needed to escape the crowd. Hey, Asuna, why don't you just go up to my room for a bit and watch some Crunchyroll and chill? I know, man, I'm smooth. So we watch 5 or so minutes of anime and things start to heat up. But before we get our serious tickling faces on, I go put a sock on the door like any gentlemanly tickler would know to do. So about 2 minutes pass and I ignore it for a bit, but my phone just keeps blowing up. So I check it and it's from my roommates. Hey, can we come in just for a minute to drop off some merch? You guys can't be serious. Asuna just laughs and says to let them in, and I open the door. So here's the thing. I was actually splitting the room with 4 other guys. The only 2 important ones to this story are my brother, and let's just call the other one Sean. Just kidding. His name is actually Sean, and he will be publicly shamed on my channel for his crimes. So my brother and Sean walk in with some merch, sees me in bed with a girl, and decides, hey, now's a perfectly good time to strike up a conversation with Matt's new friend.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Major props to Asuna. She legitimately held a conversation with these two for a solid 10 minutes before my death stare finally registered and they left. Needless to say, they kind of ruined the moment and we both just decided to head back to the convention. So a couple hours pass and it was starting to get late. My time was running short, and I knew if I was going to make a move, it would have to be soon. But the question was how. Hey, I kinda want to take a break from the con for a bit. Is it cool if we went back to your room to hang? If only the rest of my problems were solved so easily. So Asuna and I show up to the room to find all of my roommates drinking. I had kind of expected this since it was already 9-ish, but I had a plan to get them out. One of our favorite panels was about to happen, and I knew none of them were going to miss it. So I might have exaggerated a bit and said the line for the panel was already close to getting capped, and if they wanted to get there, they'd all have to leave right now. So three moderately drunk weebs all scrambled up and bolted out of the room. This is when I noticed my brother. You see, he wasn't moderately drunk. He was smashed. He was insistent on hanging out with me and Asuna, so I knew giving him death glares and hints wasn't going to work. So I texted him to leave the room and find something else to do. Then promptly told him to check his phone because, of course, he was so drunk he hadn't noticed it went off. Finally, he understood, got up, and left the room. Hallelujah. Now, time to... Matt, the funniest thing just happened to me. I went down to the lobby, and I totally forgot what I was gonna do. And my brother just walks back in the room and sits down. I just gave up after that point. I realized, hey, tickling's just not gonna happen, and I guess I'd just rather hang out with Asuna instead, since this very well may be the last time I see her. After all, I'm not from anywhere near where she lives. So we decided to go out, and we had a blast. We even got into the hilarious Hentai Dubs panel by Vitamin H, which, by the way, if you guys ever get the chance to go to that panel, I cannot recommend it enough. So after that, it was 1 a.m. and things were winding down. All of the panels had wrapped for the night, and my roommates had blocked my attempts at tickling twice in the same day. But then again, I was just having plenty of fun being around this girl. Asuna smiled and said, hey, are we gonna tickle or not? I'm not gonna lie, I've never been asked that question before, but I'll be damned if the answer is going to be no. So at this point, it's way too late for the room to be an option anymore. I'm positive most of my roommates are passed out drunk by now, or at the very least, one is. So we try to find a secluded place around the convention. But I never noticed this before. Akon has a full patrol of volunteers scouring the convention. So needless to say, it was impossible to find a good spot. So Asuna comes up with a final suggestion. Why not your room's bathroom? This is when I realize that I really don't care about my roommate's opinion of me anymore. I mean, after all, they're all probably in drunken stupors anyway. So we sneak into the room and check and see that everyone is passed out drunk. We open the door to the bathroom, and there it was. Well, he was. My roommate, Sean. Passed out drunk, over the toilet, puke everywhere. I guess we should go call you an Uber. And after that, that was the last time I saw her. Luckily, we were such good friends that we've actually kept in contact over the past couple of years. We go back and forth and talk, and she's honestly one of my best friends I've made at a con. Actually, before I made this video, I asked her if she would be cool with it. I didn't get a yes, I got an absolutely, and please send me the link the second it's live. I think, at the end of the day, the moral to this story is... you, Sean. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching, and sorry about not uploading last week. I was spending all that time making this video. Also, awesome announcement, I actually have my entire con schedule for this summer lined up. I will be at Anime Expo this July, and I might be hosting a meetup. So if you're interested in that, and you also happen to be going to Anime Expo yourself, feel free to let me know on Twitter, or just say something in the comments down below. Secondly, at the end of July, I will be a special guest at MechaCon in New Orleans. I actually get to run some of my own panels, so if you happen to be there, feel free to swing by and say hello. Final bit of news, I promise, unless you already saw it on Twitter, I'm actually moving my upload dates to Sundays at 1 p.m. Pacific instead of Saturdays. This is honestly just a last-ditch effort to try to recover some of my views. YouTube senpai, please be gentle. Well, I feel like I haven't slept in a week, but a huge thank you to my patrons, You guys are my heroes. Thank you guys so much for staying up with me and making sure I finish this project on time. Speaking of which, if you want to join my editing live streams or just be a part of the Discord or simply support the channel, feel free to join me on Patreon. Make sure you guys share, like, comment, and subscribe. This has been Matt. Make sure you guys say amen and go watch that goddamned anime!